Hello everyone and welcome to the start of a new journey on the channel, and that is my secret number series. I was super excited to start this journey because if you've seen my discovery episode with them in there, you would know that they were one of my favorite last month in terms of album. That was just a masterpiece. It stayed with me. I listened to the songs constantly and I was really, really impressed. So I was really excited to start this journey. A couple of things before I get into today's album. I want to say that it's always going to be reviews and not reaction, and that's just because of the type of listener that I am. I'm the type of person, I will listen to an album at first like a song, and then when I go and listen to it back, I realize that, you know, this is a one-time thing. Or I will not like the song, but then later down the line, find out that this is actually the one that I replay the most. And the number one thing that I look for in a favorite is replay value. And the sole reason I started this whole journey in the first place was because I was looking for song for my playlist. I've always been a fan of K-pop. It's just I've always sticked to soloists because I've been afraid of members leaving, just changes that happen within the group and waking up one morning saying, you know what, they've disbanded and all that. I knew that at least with the soloists, either they went on a very long hiatus or, you know, they would just take a little break from time to time. And so I avoided groups for the longest time until last year, where I felt like all of my favorites were not having a comeback at all. And seeing every day groups come back, and I felt like I was missing out on something, and I decided to just, you know, check groups out and see. The worst that can happen is be sad, but then, you know, things will always look up. Then so my thing is mainly to look for songs that I can fall in love with, I can listen to it to every day. That's the goal here. So the number one thing that I look for is replay value. And I feel like only by doing reviews will I really be true to who I am as a person and as a listener. I want to be sure that when I say this song is my favorite in the album, it's really my favorite. I've gone through so many mood and this song still has the same impact on me. Also, I want to focus on positive things, and I feel like by doing reviews, I can do them in a format that allows me to only talk about the stuff that I like. Of course, if it's relevant to the conversation to mention something that I did not like, I would. Like, for example, an album being underwhelming or me not liking a certain song, but that's the end of it. I really hate when somebody bashes my favorites under the guise of criticism. So I don't want to do that to anybody else's favorite. If it's relevant to the conversation, I will mention it and then we'll move on from there. But for the most part, I want this place to be focusing on positive things and positive things only. Now, on to today's album. Today's album is Got That Boom. And once again, I'm really impressed by Secret Number. Oh my God. Like, how can they be so good so early on their career? They sing like they've been around for 10 plus years. I just love how much work is put into the album. Something that I've been complaining lately is how songs have a very limited shelf life lately. It's like music is just made for the next 2 weeks and then we move on to the next thing. But you know, now and again, you find some artists that still putting work, still pay attention to the quality of their music and put out something that will really have a long shelf life, like something that you can enjoy for forever, actually. And I think that's the thing with Secret Number Music. It's something that you can enjoy now. You can enjoy a month from now, a year from now, 3 years from now. The song will still hit the same. And I really like it. The album was just so great. I love the energy. I'm personally not a fan of single albums, but I understand that they do serve their purpose. I just wish there will be a point in time where we get a mini album or even a full album by them, because the music is so good. Why are you feeding us in small doses every time? Like, give us a lot of songs. They are just so good, and by the time the album is over, you just want to go back in and listen to it again. The vocals, the energy, the melody, everything was just picked perfectly and executed so well that it really came out really well. Does that make sense? I hope it does. But I really, really liked this album. Once again, both of the songs made it into my playlist, and now it's just a question of which one I enjoyed more. So far, there's not really somebody that sticks out to me. I'm still enjoying and appreciating everybody kind of the same and being wrecked by everyone. I don't have somebody that kind of, get me yet. So I look forward to that. I'm still in the process of learning their voices. I think I have one or two down, but I still have a long way to go right now. Now, like I said, I love both songs, but there's always going to be one that you like a little bit more than the other. So, number two is Privacy.
My privacy.
this was my second favorite, privacy. I just love the way they say privacy. It's so interesting. But like the song is so good, and it's just one of those that makes you want to dance, makes you want to move your body. It's super contagious. I feel like it's so catchy and interesting. I love the singing, I love the rapping, and they really just did a wonderful job with this one. Now, my favorite is Got That Boom. This was my favorite song in this album, Get That Boom. I love the energy. I love how catchy it is. Once again, they just made you like this was like having a party. It's just such a nice vibe. I really, really like it. It's fun. It's something that you would have on repeat. It's easy to listen to, easy to love, and I'm really excited for what this journey is going to end up looking or sounding rather like. And oh, I'm excited because now with every album they just impress me more and more, so I'm pumped. Let me know in the comments how you felt about this album, which song was your favorite, also who's your bias or your bias line, what's your favorite song and album when it comes to Secret Number, and don't forget to leave a like, comment, and subscribe.